Long ago, about 2 weeks ago, in the land of Menchaca, four mortals embark bravely on a quest for speech class to unravel the ancient secrets of children's playthings. The lads had their monster trucks and action heroes, while the ladies have baby dolls and kitchen sets. Each sex has her own toy box, locked full of age-old stereotypes and conventional trinkets. But the question is why?
These four men seek to unlock that box. This is their story.
This Rolando is a definition of style.
Un momento! Before we go into today's stories, let's talk about Los Viejos Tiempos.
Los Viejos Tiempos!
The old times!
The first toys date back as far as 3000 BC. The earliest are believed to be items found in nature, such as rocks and steel.
In ancient Egypt, children played with first documented dolls, constructed from stone, pottery and wood. In ancient Greece, kids had dolls as well. In addition to bows and arrows, shoes, and instruments, little horse on wheels.
Sure.
It was also a tradition for children to sacrifice their childhood toys when they came of age.
Sure.
Toys really began to take off during the Enlightenment. The first jigsaw puzzle was created in 1767 to help kids learn geography.
The rocking horse was developed around the same time in England for wealthy children and thought to help them with their balance for riding real horses. By the 19th century, toys were valued by society worldwide as educational tools.
In conclusion, prior to the turn of the 20th century, toys were designed and used without regard to the child's sex.
We interrupt our program to bring you this important message.
On our broadcast tonight, is it the plane? Quite frankly, I don't know. I don't really care. We have a much more pressing development being covered by a local news team that goes by the name Cram4. Suggesting hidden evidence and a link between toys and gender stereotypes. Here with you live is Gohan and Baby Rolanda from Cram 4 News.
Let it bump though.
Cram 4 Public Broadcasting is brought to you in part by
Dr. Menchaca, speech for the stars.
Welcome to Cram 4. This is Gohan.
And Rolanda and Ahosa.
And we're here to talk about toys.
Oh, yeah.
Let's take a look at boys' toys. Lots of boys' toys portray construction, guns, action figures, not dolls. Muscular appearances such as Army, Power Rangers, Pirates, and superheroes.
That's so cool. But take a look at the bright, pretty, sparkly, and fluorescent toys for girls. Why can't boys play with this? Oh wait, my fault. The toys are teaching and influencing little children to cook, clean, and take care of babies. What do you think?
I believe that's absolutely correct. For boys is growing up non-verbally. They're showing us that we need to build, we also need to provide for everyone, and we're also growing up to be the protectors of our families. Many of our colors, if you take a look, include blue, green, black, orange, and also camouflage.
As well as women. You know, non-verbally, those toys are showing little girls how to fill the role of a middle to high-class woman in society today. Also, by displaying very colorful colors you normally wouldn't see boys associating with. Verbally, sayings like, "Welcome, princess," would definitely indicate that those toys are for girls only. What do you say?
Well, as opposed to girls who wear pink fluorescent colors. However, verbally, boys' toys use actions such as
Extreme Shocks Mega Stunt Pack! Dragon Destroyer! Getting Dirty!
Alarm Clock!
No, Gohan!
Maximum Destruction Battle!
40 pieces!
No, Gohan!
Hey, Peppa checking in here.
What up, dog?
Did you guys know there are games and toys that are meant for boys and girls? Some examples include board games, Bop-It, and sports. Do you know there's women's basketball? Toys like this can be played by anyone. How these toys communicate verbally is by using opening the words like fun and exciting. Non-verbally by colors such as earth tones, white, black, and brown. Just like me, Pepe.
Thanks, Pepe, for that new point of view. What do you think, Rolanda?
Well, I think the home dog is speaking the truth over here.
All right, speech class, that's it for...
So far, we've seen how toys both verbally and non-verbally communicate masculinity and femininity, as well as gender role expectations. Did you know there's an entire aisle at Toys R Us dedicated to Home Depot brand toys for little boys? Is it not cool for females to build and fix things? And another interesting fact, every single doll on display has a girl on the box. I know it sounds silly, a boy playing with the doll, but maybe society has made us that way. I mean, is it not cool for males to take care of children? With stereotypes being encrypted into boys' heads at an early age, it's no wonder our society has so many deadbeat dads and a rising number of girls with daddy issues. In this next segment, we go straight to the source, the kids, to find out their standpoint on what's in their toy box.
Are there any tow trucks for girls? Really? Why not?
Up there is Barbie's. Barbie's has Corvettes.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Boys are better than girls.
Why?
Because boys are stronger than the girls sometimes.
What would happen if you put on a dress? Which doll likes to clean the house?
This one.
Who takes care of the babies?
This one.
Who goes to work?
This one.
Guys, we've been having complaints. We can't be having you guys filming in here.
What? Well, we're doing a project for school.
It doesn't matter what it's for. We have a strong no soliciting policy. You guys can't be filming people's kids.
It's for school, though.
It doesn't matter. You can't be doing that here, and if you keep doing it, you need to leave.
So Rolando is a definition of style.
No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, we just got kicked out of Toys R Us. You know, they didn't like what we was doing, so. Yeah.
You're brainwashing kids! Go, go!
Alright, we're here at Walmart because we got kicked out of at Toys R Us. We're looking to interview some kids. And so that's what we're doing here. Oh, there's one right there. Let's go. All right, ma'am. I was wondering if I could ask you a few questions. Do you mind?
Hi, scary man.
Hello. My name's Anthony. What's your name?
Drew.
Hi, Drew. I have a few questions for you. So what kind of toys do you like?
Bunnies.
Bunnies? Why do you like bunnies?
Because they're fuzzy and cute.
Oh, I love bunnies, too. I used to have one. Good. What attracts you to... girl toys, like the colors, smiles, what do you like?
I like pink and sparkles.
And who do you want to be when you grow up?
Kesha.
Kesha? I love Kesha.
Wrestlers would you like to have?
Like John Cena.
John Cena?
Yeah.
Why John Cena?
Because I think he'd probably be the best wrestler.
He's the best wrestler?
Yeah.
Do you like his muscles? Would you want to look like that when you're older?
Yeah? Yeah.
Would you want to wrestle like him?
Yeah.
Yeah? Would you, what about girl wrestlers? You like girl wrestlers? Nah? Yeah. Are they boring or are they skinny or you don't like the colors? I don't know.
They're boring.
They're boring?
Yeah.
You guys cannot be interviewing kids.
We're doing this for school. Wait, aren't you the same guy that kicked us out from Toys R Us?
Yeah, I am. A guy can work two jobs. Do you not believe that? What's wrong with kids these days?
Well, why don't you tell us what's wrong with kids nowadays? You are brainwashing children at Toys R Us and Walmart. Yeah, we know everyone's heard of Alex from Target. We actually have John from Walmart here.
Get that out of my face. Good times for a change. Are you guys aware of what Judith Butler's gender theory is?
No.
How ignorant are you guys?
Dude, you work at Walmart.
And Toys R Us. Good times
for a change. Okay, Mr. John from Walmart and Toys R Us, what is Judith Butler's gender theory?
I'm gonna explain to you. It basically says that the repetition of people's actions are gonna influence how they're gonna act later in life. This is telling women they need to clean the house.
Thanks to Mr. John from Walmart and Toys R Us for defining the Judith Butler gender theory. These ideals have been a recurring concept throughout this CRAM broadcast. Now, onto our final segment, all about artifacts.
An artifact is basically a personal object that has some symbolic meaning. Collectively, the CRAM team has agreed toys and artifacts have some influence on reinforcing their gender expectations, although they didn't realize it until this project.
You will now meet Sean, a young man fascinated by many different artifacts. The CRAM team estimates at least 2 childhood artifacts per kid will have a later impact on what kind of person they turn out to be. Let's see what Sean likes and how it may affect him in the future.
Strong.
Believe to real when I feel what my heart can't conceal.
I want superpowers when I grow up.
It's fine.
I'm so strong!
Man, you forgot you were the ogre in today.
No, Gohan! No, Gohan! No!
Oh.
No, Gohan!
Hello, everybody! My name is Rototo. My parents were eaten by lions. I was left all alone.